But you asked the minister to resign. You want the board to step aside. You want top management to step aside. And what happened to the funds?
According to Dr. Peter Chimbowa, the chairman of the NSSF board, their silence as leaders does not mean that they entirely agree with the report findings of Parliament's Select Committee that was probing NSSF. He noted that it's inappropriate to implicate the officials without enough evidence. Chimbowa says the 6 billion shillings was never disbursed, nor was the 1.8 billion shillings. He says they are still waiting for the work plan to start using the money.
6 billion, as David Dee has mentioned, 6 billion is in the plan to expand coverage and also ensure that there is compliance. That's what the MD has mentioned, and that's what is the fact. As a board, this is a suggestion and an idea that we got to hear and got to understand that there is a need to expand our relevance and deepen and broaden value creation at the lowest level possible. So that was a very big initiative. It was still a plan and budgeted for, but authority to plan is very different from authority to spend. So the board is waiting for the plan and work plan. The general perception in the public has been that a bag was brought to the fund and was filled with 6 billion and taken to Ministry of Labour. That is a very exciting thing to hear and nice, but it did not happen. The 6 billion is here and growing on behalf of members. Number two, the 1.8 billion, which was also mentioned, that the bag was brought here with 1.8 billion and shared among board members as they wished, or according to the list that the MD, the former MD, mentioned. Now, that list, I must state clearly, that list was in the imagination faculty of the MOD. 1.8 billion is a block figure placed in the budget, but without a plan. So we needed a plan, a real good work plan, to release the 1.8 billion to move into corporate social responsibility activities. The money, 1.8 billion, is still intact in the fund and growing on behalf of the members. So there was no money stolen at all. There has been no stealing. Because the moment you say, I've stolen, you present the evidence that this is where the board members signed and they took the 1.8
billion shillings. It was approved in the budget all the way from the board, going from management board up to the minister. And then you then allude to an illegality. I don't know how you call it an illegality. If it was approved properly for activities that are considered for the board. And as the chairman has said, the board is still waiting for the work plans, and then they will approve those work plans that do two things. Increase coverage, and number two, improve compliance, which are actually the mandate of the fund.
Chimbowa said that the parliament's report contained a lot of inaccuracies.
And representing my colleagues on the board, our fiduciary responsibility is key to provide oversight, and also not only to provide oversight, but to provide foresight and even insight. We have not and will not compromise on this duty, as all members of NSSF will need to be assured of prudent and profitable management of their resources for the future.
Patrick Ayota, the acting managing director of NSSF, boasted of the good performance of the fund and assured the workers serving with the body that their funds are safe and secure.
Because of the way things were presented, and I want to assure members that, and we'll conclude with that actually the savings of the members are safe. We have grown the fund from 1.7 trillion and we're going to see 18 trillion shillings in just 12 years.
The parliamentary NSSF probe that instituted a seven-member committee unearthed startling revelations about governance of the fund, power fights, and political influence peddling at the entity, as well as questionable handling of cash at the entity. Report compiled by Jaliet Namuwaya for the news.